it's 2 o'clock, so I think we'll go ahead and get started. And I'm Jess Hayden. On behalf of the Susquehanna Folk Music Society, I'm pleased to welcome you to this very special family program with the Beverley Street String Band. We're pleased to be able to partner today with the York County Libraries, the Dauphin County Library System, and Hershey Library. I see that everyone is on mute, so we ask to please stay on mute during the show unless you are asked to unmute yourselves. Susquehanna Folk Music Society has two more family programs in this partnership series, including on June 30th, 2 p.m., Cups and Crankies, Homegrown Family Fun, and on July 14th, Andy's Wild Amphibian Show, featuring storyteller Andy Offit Irwin. We'd also like to let you know that today's program is sponsored by an Arts for All grant and funding from the Cultural Alliance of York County and the National Endowment for the Arts and the Pennsylvania Council of the Arts. Now I'd like to play a short video made by Miss Karen of Redland Community Library, which will welcome you to today's show. So just let me get that screen shared and I'll be with you in a minute.
Hello, SummerQuest readers. I am Miss Karen from Redland Library, and I am so happy to welcome you to the first of our three programs in partnership with the Susquehanna Folk Festival. Summer in our libraries is filled with reading and fun programs and crafts and prizes, and the best part of all is that we can all visit with each other again. Enjoy the Beverley Street musicians, and we'll see you soon in the library. Bye.
Now join me in welcoming with some silent clapping the Beverley Street String Band. So Dave, I believe you have to unmute them. Oh, maybe they could. Oh, there they got it.
Hey, okay. Here we are. Hello, everybody. Well, my name's Bill, and here we have Janie and Allan, and we are Beverley Street, and we are happy to be here today, and we like to play folk music. We're so happy to be here as part of the Susquehanna Folk Festival. And one of the great things about folk music, Janie and Allan and everybody else, is that folk songs are songs everybody knows. These are songs we've known since we were little kids. And when we get together, we can just sing them. So I thought today we would just start off and sing everybody's favorite folk song. Everybody knows this one. It's called Old Sheeby.
What?
I knew you'd be a
Sheeby.
Huh? Come on, you know Old Sheeby.
No.
You guys, you guys know Old Sheeby, right? Really? Oh, okay. Well, I'll be glad to teach it to you. It's a really cool song. Old Sheeby, it goes like this. She be coming round the mountain. She's coming. Yeah, I told you. She be coming. Everybody knows this one, yeah. Sing along. She be coming round the mountain. Coming round the mountain. I say, coming round the mountain when she comes. She be driving 6 white horses when she comes. Yep. She be driving 6 white horses when she comes. She be driving 6 white horses. Driving 6 white horses. She gets here, I was heard she's gonna be wearing like pink pajamas.
Pink pajamas.
Yeah. So let me ask you a question. Would you go around the mountain driving 6 white horses while wearing pink pajamas?
Absolutely.
No. Well, you know, I don't know, but she would. She'd be wearing pink pajamas when she comes. Everybody. When she gets there, we're going to send up for some special food.
Oh,
it's called chocolate pizza.
Ew.
Well, yeah, well, don't knock it till you tried it. It couldn't be any worse than pepperoni pancakes.
No. Oh.
Well, gets here, we're just going to have a big old party. We'll stay up all night long and say all our favorite jokes, like knock, knock.
Who's there?
Emerson.
Emerson who?
Emerson, cool sneakers you got on there, Judy. Or maybe we'll do one like knock, knock.
Who's there?
Cowgo.
Cowgo who?
Cowgo moo. Or what did old McDonald say when the cow stepped on his toe?
What did he say?
He said E-I-E-I-ow.
Oh.
Well, you know how all good things must come to an end. So one day she be leaving. But then one day maybe she be coming back. And when she be coming back, we be singing like this. She be coming round the back way. She got everybody. She be coming round the back way. She comes. Yee-haw. She be coming round. Give yourselves a large round of applause, all you people in the audience who made it through that whole song. Just think, really good job. Yeah, really, give yourselves a large round of applause. But I got to tell you, Allan and Janie, this is kind of bad news. But there are people who say to me, Bill, I don't like folk music.
What?
And I say, why? And they say, because folk music is too simple. I require music that is more complicated. Well, these people are wrong, 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 because folk music can be very complicated. In fact, I know a folk song. It is so complicated that whenever I sing it, I always forget the words. So I'll try it out on you people, and maybe you can help out when it comes time. But I'll show you how complicated it is. It goes like this. Magdalena Hagalina Okanaka Wakataka Okanokapoka was her name. Try that. Magdalena Hagalina Okanaka Wakataka Okanoka Woka. You got one more chance. Go ahead and say Magdalena Hagalina Okanaka Wakataka Okanoka Poka was her name. See, that's the easy part. She had two hairs in the middle of her head. One was alive and the other was
dead.
Oh, Magdalena Hagalina Okanaka Wakataka Okanoka Poka was her name. She had two teeth in the middle of her mouth. One pointed north and the other pointed
south.
Oh, Magdalena Hagalina Okanaka Wakataka Okanoka Poka was her name. She had two feet size 11 and a half. One took a shower while the other took a
bath.
Oh, Magdalena Hagalina Okanaka Wakataka Okanoka Poka was her
name.
Are you sure?
Yes.
Well then, let's play some old time music. Music, not that just it's not just for old people either, you know, but it's great for all people, and it's called old time music. But now, everybody, I got really good news for you, and that is you all have to stand up. Everybody up. Now, we're not going to stand up because we'll go out of the picture, but you can see what we want you to do right here. So everybody up, and now everybody, to be successful in this part of the program, all you have to do is everything I do. So keep your eye on me and just do everything I do and you'll do fine. Here we go. The Princess Pat.
The Princess Pat.
Lived in a tree.
Lived in a tree.
And she sailed across.
And she sailed across.
The seven seas.
The seven seas.
Seas. She sailed across.
She sailed across
the channel to
the channel to.
And she brought with her.
She brought with her
a rig of bamboo.
A rig of bamboo.
A rig of bamboo.
A rig of bamboo.
Now what is that?
Now what is that?
It's something made.
Something made
by the Princess Pat.
By the Princess Pat.
It's red and gold.
It's red and gold.
And purple too.
And purple too.
That's why it's called.
That's why it's called.
A rig of bamboo.
A rig of bamboo.
Now Captain Jack.
Now Captain. Captain Jack
had a mighty fine crew.
Had a mighty fine crew.
They sailed across.
They sailed across
the Channel to
the Channel to.
But their boat sunk.
But their boat sunk.
And yours will too.
And yours will too.
If you don't bring,
if you don't bring
a rig of bamboo,
a rig of bamboo,
a rig of bamboo,
a rig of bamboo.
A rig of bamboo. Now what is that?
Now what is that?
It's something made.
It's something made
by the Princess Pack.
By the Princess Pack.
It's red and gold.
It's red and gold.
And purple too.
And purple too.
That's why it's called.
That's why it's called
a rig of bamboo.
A rig of bamboo.
Give yourselves an extra large round of applause. Man, that was fabulous and not too bad either. So now, I got to tell you guys, I don't know about you, but have you heard of this place? It's called School.
Yep.
It's a really cool place to go. And I've been to a few schools, and I found out something about all these schools. Mostly I went to elementary schools, but this is most of what I'm about to say is true of all schools, and that is it takes a lot of people to run an elementary school. Think about it. Well, you need bus drivers.
Yep.
You need cafeteria workers.
Yep.
You need custodians.
Yep.
You need secretaries.
Yep. Yep.
All these people, and yet I didn't even mention you need teachers.
Uh-huh.
All kinds of teachers. Classroom teacher, music teacher, art teacher, physical education teacher.
Yeah.
You need a media specialist. And you also need a principal, an assistant principal, and you need a nurse.
Yes.
Yes.
But you don't need a dog.
No.
No, you really don't. To run a school,
I mean,
like dogs a lot, but you don't need a dog to run a school. Now, if I do see a dog in a school, here's what I always say. There's a dog in the school. Oh, no. What are we going to do? As long as there are dogs in the school, they'll have to learn the alphabet. So people, put your dog paws on. We're going to woof the alphabet. Ready? Ruff, 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 ruff. Oh, now I know my ABCs. Next time, won't you ruff with me? So you call up the dog's mom. She comes and takes the dog away. You think everything is okay, then guess what? There's a chicken in the school. Oh no! What are we going to do? As long as there are chickens in the school, they'll have to learn the alphabet. Put your chicken wings on, here we go! Chicken's mom comes and takes the chicken away. You think everything is okay, then guess what?
There's a pig in the school.
Oh no. What are we going to do? Well, as long as there are pigs in the school, they'll have to learn the alphabet. Okay, everybody, look out. Here we go. Come to take the pig away. You think everything is okay? And then guess what? There are some children in the school.
Oh, yes.
Here's what we're going to do. Well, as long as you children are going to school, you have to learn the alphabet. How does it really go, you guys? A, B, C, D, E, F, G. H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, and Z. Now I know my ABCs. Next time, won't you sing with me? Oh, give yourselves extra large with chocolate sauce on it. Round of applause. Oh my goodness, that was amazing. Totally. All right. Okay, everybody. Well, as you can see, Janie and Allan and I are working together. We're cooperating to bring you this concert. In fact, let's think about this word cooperation. The word cooperation means working together to get something done. And here we are cooperating, and it's working really well. But I want to tell you about a story about cooperation when there wasn't any cooperation. Now, it happened when Allan and Janie, one day down on the farm, nobody could get along. I mean, horse couldn't get along with donkey. Dog couldn't get along with cat. Mouse couldn't get along with rat. And pig couldn't get along with cow. And oh, back in the farmhouse, oh, Ma and Pa, they couldn't get along so well either. And there was Pa, he's laying on the couch. He's got the remote in his hand, and he's watching TV, and he's going click, 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 click. Ma click, comes in, she click, says, Pa, what are you doing? He says, I'm watching TV. Click, click, click. She click, says, you're not click, watching, you just click. And he says, that's because nothing good's on. Click, 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 click. Well, if nothing good's click, on, what are you click, watching for? Click, some good click, Ma, come on. Click, 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 click. She said, Pa! He said, what? Pa, don't you remember last spring we planted in the ground little baby yams? Well, those little baby yams are big now, and it's time to pick them. And it's going to freeze tonight. If we don't pick them today, we're going to lose a whole crop. So, Pa, you got to put down that thing, put down that clicker, and come out and help me. And Pa said, all right. And he put down that clicker, and he went and got his yam picking stick. Now, yams, they're like a sweet potato. They grow in the ground. You got to dig them out to get them. You got to dig them out. So they went out in the garden, and they started picking those yams, and I put them in the basket. Picking those yams, and I put them in the basket. Picking those yams, and I put them in the basket. Picking those yams, and I put them in the basket. All of a sudden, Pa came to one really big yam. It was the biggest one you ever seen. Why? It was so big, he tried digging it out, he tried pulling it out, he tried pushing it out, he couldn't get it out. No how, no way, all by himself. He was gonna need some
help.
Yeah, otherwise known as cooperation. So he called over to Ma. I said, Ma, come over here, see if you can help me get this big one out of the ground. And here's what happened. Pa grabbed a hold of that yam, and Ma put her arms around Pa's waist, and I'm going to say Pa was a pulling that yam.
Oh, yeah.
I want you all to say yeah like that. Oh yeah, ready? Pa was a pulling that yam. Oh yeah. Ma was a pulling that yam.
Oh yeah.
Ma was a pulling that yam.
Oh yeah.
And Pa was a pulling that yam.
Oh yeah.
All of a sudden, Ma stopped to say, "What did she say?" She said, "Ooh-wee, this is hard work." The minute she said that, why, who should hear her but horse and donkey? They came out to see if they couldn't help too. Now, horse put his arms around Ma's waist, and donkey put his arms around horse's waist. And what were they doing, people? They were pulling that yam. And Pa was a pulling that yam.
Oh, yeah.
And Ma was a pulling that yam.
Oh, yeah.
And horse was a pulling that yam.
Oh, yeah.
Donkey was a pulling that yam.
Oh, yeah.
All of a sudden, donkey stopped to say, what did donkey say? Donkey said, ooh, this is hard work. What? The minute donkey said that, who should hear him but dog and cat? They forgot what they were arguing about. Came over, see if they couldn't help too. So dog put his arms around donkey's waist, and cat put her arms around dog's waist. Oh, yes, she did. And what were they doing, people? They were
pulling that yam.
And Pa was a pulling that yam.
Oh, yeah.
And Ma was a pulling that yam.
Oh, yeah.
And horse was pulling that yam.
Oh, yeah.
Donkey was a pulling that yam.
Oh, yeah.
Dog was a pulling that yam.
Oh, yeah.
Cat was a pulling that yam.
Oh, yeah.
All of a sudden, cat stopped to say, what did cat say? Cat said, ew-wee, this is hard work. The minute cat said that, who should hear her but mouse and rat? And so they come running over, see if they couldn't help too. Now, mouse, he put his arms around cat's waist. Oh, yes, he did. Rat put his arms around mouse's waist. And what were they doing, people? They were
pulling that yam.
And Pa was a pulling that yam.
Oh, yeah.
And Ma was a pulling that yam.
Oh, yeah.
Horse was a pulling that yam.
Oh, yeah.
Donkey was a pulling that yam.
Oh, yeah.
Dog was a pulling that yam.
Oh, yeah.
Cat was a pulling that yam.
Oh, yeah.
Mouse was a pulling that yam.
Oh, yeah.
Rat was a pulling that yam.
Oh, yeah.
All of a sudden, they stopped, and what did Rat say? Rat said, my, isn't this difficult labor? Minute he said that, who should hear him but pig and cow? Well, they came running over, see if they couldn't help too. Now, Pig put his arms around Rat's waist. Oh, yes, he did. And Mouse put his arms around Rat's waist. And what were they doing, people? They were
pulling that yam.
And Ma was pulling that yam.
Oh, yeah.
And Pa was pulling that yam.
Oh, yeah.
And Horse was pulling that yam.
Oh, yeah.
Donkey was pulling that yam.
Oh, yeah.
Dog was pulling that yam.
Oh, yeah.
Cat was pulling that yam.
Oh, yeah.
Rat was a pulling that yam.
Oh, yeah.
Cow was a pulling that yam.
Oh, yeah.
Cow was a pulling that yam.
Oh, yeah.
All of a sudden, that big old yam just popped out of the ground. Oh. Oh, with everybody pulling it together like that, it didn't stand a chance. And Ma ran inside and got her best knife and cut it up and cut it up. And I heard they had broiled yams, french fried yams, yam pie, yam pudding. Oh, I even had strawberry yam. I went over there for breakfast last week, Allan and Janie. I went over there for breakfast. And yeah. You know what we had?
What'd you have?
We had yam and eggs. And Ma was a pulling that yam.
Oh, yeah.
And Pa was a pulling that yam.
Oh, yeah.
And the horse and the donkey and the dog and the cat and the pig and the rat and the mouse and the rat and everybody's pulling that yam.
Oh yeah.
Give yourselves another big yam hand, boys and girls. Yeah. That was fabulous. Yeah. You did a really, really good job. All right, now.
Good at you, Bill.
Yeah.
Ooh, would you like a drink of water?
Ooh, would you like
some? How about a nap?
Later.
Oh, okay. All right. Let's see. Okay.
Oh, we have a song.
Okay. We do have a song for you right now. Ladies and gentlemen, I have been to a lot of schools, like I said, and I met this guy one time at a school. He was so entirely awesome. In fact, we're going to sing a song entirely dedicated to this one guy. You guys ready?
Yeah,
this is the ballad of Gnarly Road Rash. Well, there once was a radical kid. He was cool at all he did. He said, hey, dude, it was really rude. And he did 3 seconds on the skateboard, too. He wore cool surfer clothes. He had earrings in his nose. Talked and jive, he ate 5 fives. He cool wherever he goes. Oh, that awesome dude is Gnarly Road Rash. He is a real flash. He makes a big splash. And while on his skateboard is flying, all the girls are sighing as he calls his name. See, thanks, Betty. See, nobody remembers Gnarly's real name. He was a kid who, like a lot of kids, wanted a skateboard real bad. And that's how he did it. Real bad. Every time he got on the skateboard, he fell off. He got back on, he fell off, on, off, till he had scrapes and bruises on his knee bone, and his ankle bone, his wrist bone, and his elbow bone, his wishbone, his funny bone, and his trombone. Till one day on the playground, a kid named Freddy said to him, man, your entire body, you look like one big gnarly road rash. And that is how this ultimately radical dude got the name that would carry him to fame. What name is that?
Gnarly Road Rash.
Of course, he still couldn't skateboard very well, but he didn't give up. Like Thomas Edison, Gnarly believed that skateboarding is 2% inspiration, 98% perspiration. So every day he perspired in the persistent pursuit of perfection upon the precarious platform that presently propels the preponderance of our prepubescence, the skateboard. Until one day, he actually stayed on the thing for longer than 10 seconds.
Wow.
Then he stayed on for 30 seconds.
Wow.
And then a whole minute. So after many weeks of practice, he went back to the playground. All the other kids saw him coming. They said, hey, man, here comes Gnarly. This Western fellow has a skateboard. This is kind of fun. And Gnarly got on his skateboard, and he did a 360. He did a 720, a 1440, a 2880, a 5960. He's going around and around so fast that nobody could count. He jumped off the skateboard. All the other kids said,
Dude, that was awesome.
And they all sang, oh, that awesome dude is Gnarly Road Rash. He is a real flash. He makes a big splash. And while on his skateboard he is flying, all the girls are sighing as he calls his name. Thank you, everybody, and give yourselves another large round of applause for making it through another song. And now I got a special surprise. You know, Janie.
What's that, Bill?
Well, you've all been noticing how what a great, great fiddle player Janie is.
You.
She's just my inspiration. She's so good. In fact, I'm so inspired by Janie, I've decided to learn to play the fiddle myself. Yeah. And so I've been working on it. And I don't, but it's something's
wrong.
Well,
Bill, I gotta hand it to you.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you, Allie. Okay, well, you know, see, because what I'm doing, there must be something wrong, because it just doesn't seem to sound like when you do it. Anything like it. See, I'll show you tell me what I'm doing wrong, because I think what you're supposed to do is you're supposed to go like this, see? But I don't even get any noise at all.
The other way.
Yeah. Okay, there we go. I mean, like there we go. How's that?
The other way.
We're getting now. Hey, look at that.
That's
sound really good, but
under your chin.
Really?
Under your
chin.
Okay. Under my chin. I don't get this at all.
Under your other chin.
No. Hey, I can't believe you told me to do that. In front of all these people. I mean, like that, like that,
yeah,
like
that, one.
Like that kind of in my chin.
Yeah.
That.
Wow.
It's still kind of weird, don't you think?
Oh,
it works better though. Yeah. Hey, nothing to this really.
Yeah.
You guys can clap along.
Yeah.
Woo! It's really kind of a lot of fun. You ought to try it. It really is cool. It's fiddle playing. It's one of the best things they ever did.
Yeah.
Okay, and now we're going to sing it. We're going to do a little song about a chicken.
Yeah.
Good time. Sorry, farmyard and barnyard.
Can you play your banjo with
I'm
this I'm going to
play my
though?
Banjo.
Right.
That's what I'm going to do. You want to put that one back over there?
Oh,
I'll
sure.
hand it back to you.
Well, this
sure.
is one of our
All
favorite
right.
old-time songs to sing and play. You may have heard
okay,
before.
We'll just leave it there.
And you can sing along, too. It's called Cluck Old Hen. Cluck old hen, cluck and sing.
See, they already practiced because they've been clucking in the other song. So they're all ready to go. All right.
Cluck old hen, cluck and sing. Ain't laid an egg since late last
spring.
Spring. Cluck old hens, cluck and squall. This is a rhyming thing, Bill,
I'm,
right?
I'm trying to listen here. How's it go?
Ain't laid an egg since late last
fall.
Oh, there
wow.
you go.
Did you guys get that too?
And if you can't remember, just sing Cluck Old Hen. We'll sing it a lot. Enjoy having a fun time playing this song.
Let's go.
Right.
Here we go. Quarters here, folks.
Yep.
Doing the best we can with what
all
we
right.
have.
Good job, guys.
All right. Okay. Well, You know, I do this thing called Radio WOOF. Radio WOOF stands for the World of Folklore, and you can find a lot of Radio WOOF on YouTube. In fact, you can find all Radio WOOF on YouTube. My name is Bill Wellington. Search Radio WOOF and you'll find it. And Radio WOOF is a lot of different things, but mostly it's this fun bunch of songs and stuff you can listen to and enjoy. But we're doing some serious things here at Radio WOOF too, and one of the things we're always trying to find out answers to some of the big questions. Questions like, what are some of the very first songs we all learn when we're little tiny kids? Well, it may not be the very first song, but there's one song everybody seems to know at a real early age, and that is a song that goes like this. Yeah, 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 yeah. You guys know it? Give it a try. Yeah, 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 yeah. We're kind of getting in harmony here. Try it again. That's good. So it's really a good song, and everybody seems to know it, but have you ever thought, what is this song really all about? What is the meaning of this? It must be some kind of it's some kind of code language, right? Well, actually, this song does have a very deep meaning. This is the voice of freedom. Because what you're saying essentially is, I am me, you are you. You have your space, I have my space. You are not gonna bother me in my space. Nya, 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 nya. Now, this is a very useful expression as you go through life. And you'll find all over the world there's expressions like this. For example, if you go to Thailand, I've been told, the children there don't say nya, 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 nya. What they say sounds like this. Nya, 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 nya. Give it a try. Nya, 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 nya. One more time. Nya, 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 nya. So once upon a time in Thailand, there was a hunter who went out in search of food, and he came to a tree, and he looked up, and there he saw a bird. But this wasn't any normal bird. It wasn't black or gray or brown or red or yellow or blue. This bird was entirely golden. Whoa! So he's looking up at this golden bird, and the golden bird turns and looks down back at the hunter, and the golden bird turns at the hunter and says, nya, 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 nya. Nya, 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 nya. So the hunter takes an arrow out of his quiver and puts it into his bow, and he shoots at the bird. But the bird jumps to the side, the arrow misses him, and once again the bird says, nya, 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 nya. Nya, 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 nya. So once again, the hunter takes an arrow out of his quiver, puts it into his bow, and shoots again. But this time his aim is better. He hits the bird, knocks it out of the tree, runs over, grabs the bird, stuffs it in a sack, and started walking home with his prize. Ha ha ha. But then, from within the sack, he hears, nya, 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 nya. Nya, 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 nya. So he takes the sack home, and he takes it into his house, and he takes it into his kitchen. He takes the bird, the golden bird, out of the sack, and there he plucks out all of its golden feathers. And there's the poor bird without any feathers. And the bird goes like this. Burr, 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 burr. Burr, 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 burr. So the hunter takes the bird and puts it in a pot of water, and he lights a fire underneath the water. But then from within the water, he hears. The hunter says, I can't stand it anymore. I gotta get rid of this thing. So he takes it out and he puts it on the counter, and oh, he chops it up into 100 pieces, puts the pieces inside a bag, takes it outside, puts it in the ground, made a big hole, puts the dirt back on top, and puts the dirt, and he says, now, I won't have to hear that anymore. But then, from way down in the ground, he heard. The hunter says, oh my, it's still there. I've got to get rid of it. So he digs the bag back up. This time he goes down to the river and he has a box, and he puts the bag inside the box, and he puts the box in the river. He puts a top on the box. He puts a rock on top of the box. He puts a rope around the rock on top of the box, and he ties the other end of the rope to a tree. And then he says, now. Water wore away the rope. The rope came off the rock. The rock came off the box. The box then floated on down the river and stopped at the banks of the river where there happened to be a school. The little children came out to see what this was. They pulled the box out of the river and they opened it up and looked inside, and what should they see but 100 little golden birds. And they all looked at the children and they all went, cheep, 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 cheep. Cheep, 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 cheep. And they flew away. Well, about a year later, this same hunter went back to the same forest and he came to the same tree and he looked up. But this time, instead of seeing one golden bird, he saw 100 golden birds. And they all looked down at him and they all went, na 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 na. Yeah, 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 yeah. And the hunter said, "Now, I understand. You are the freedom bird, because freedom is something you cannot kill. In fact, the more you try to kill it, smother it up, bury it, drown it, whatever, the more you make it multiply. So what the story from Thailand really tells us is that we are all the freedom bird, whether we say, yeah, 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 yeah. Or we say, yeah, 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 yeah." Wow. Give yourselves another big hand. That was really good.
Put your hand
there, Bill. Yeah. Hey, tell you what. Speaking of birds and free birds, let's do that little song about that free little bird.
Okay.
It's one of my favorite songs Jenny sings.
Yeah.
This love's cutest song ever.
You can sing along, too. I'm as free little bird as I can be. I'm as free little bird as I can be. Gonna build my nest in a weeping willow tree where the bad boys cannot
the bad
bother.
Boys.
You know, like Enoch Allen.
Yeah.
Anyway.
Are you ready, children?
We're ready. Switch it up a little bit. I'm going to take guitar away from Alan, and he's going to jump over on the big daddy of them all, the
and
bass.
I'm going to play the big fiddle.
You got that pick there.
Oh, yeah. I can't get this one under my chin.
So anyway, don't give it a try. You might hurt your back or something. But anyway, we're going to, Janie, you know, it's summertime out there, Janie. The kids are going to be out there playing and enjoying the great outdoors because now you really can, and that's wonderful news for all. But you still have to be careful. I mean, watch out for bugs and stuff. And so Janie, she's got a story to tell about what happened to her one time, so pay attention, everybody.
This is when I went to summer camp, Pine Tree Camp, in the Poconos. You better call for the counselor. You better call for the nurse. You know, I've seen some bad things, but now I've seen worse. I went to my cabin.
cover those bugs, people. Folks, it's time for me to tell you. Well, I'm going to tell these people a story out here. One of these stories that I'm going to tell is the story I'm going to tell. We're going to do the walrus. So we're going to let's do the story and then we'll do the walrus. Let's do this since we're kind of already into the story aspect. So people, I'm going to tell you a story. And have a seat, Allan, because it's going to take about 12 minutes for you to tell you this story. Relax.
It's a big story.
It's a long story, and
is this a story with a lot of action in it?
No, it's this. You guys just sit back and enjoy it.
Should I get a sandwich?
It's a little bit spooky, but don't let that get to you.
Okay, we're going to sit back and relax.
The story I'm going to tell you is about two little boys who went on trick-or-treating a couple of years back. Their names were Jimmy and Johnny. Now, Jimmy was dressed up like a little ghost. Johnny was a vampire. Well, they had a great time. They went all over town, and they were almost back home, but they still had to walk by the old spooky place. Nobody trick-or-treated the old spooky place. It was just way too spooky. So they were almost by the gate when Jimmy says to Johnny, or Johnny is, yeah, Jimmy says to Johnny, he says, I dare you to trick-or-treat the old spooky place. And Johnny says, no way, man. Nobody ever does that. Why would I? I have no incentive to do that kind of thing. Why would I want to trick-or-treat that old spooky, spooky place? And he says, because if you would trick-or-treat the old spooky place, Johnny, I would give you my granola bar.
Wow.
You're kidding. He said, you got to do better than that. He says, okay, I would give you my granola bar, but I'll also give you all my gummy worms. Okay, you get granola bar, gummy worms, and all my M&Ms. I'll do it, that's says Johnny. Standard. So he takes his bag and he walks up the long, lonely path to the old spooky place. He gets to the first step. Second step. Third step. Walks over to the front door. Now, it didn't look like anybody lived in the old spooky place because all the windows were broken out. But way inside the house, he could see there was one little light flickering. So he knocked on the front door. Deep within the house, he heard kalumph, 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 and the front door opened. Standing there was a guy. He looked just like Frankenstein's twin brother. He said, "What do you want?"
Trick or treat.
Trick or treat? What does that mean?
It means that if you don't treat me, I will trick you.
You will trick me? Very funny. And he reached around the door into a bowl, and he pulled out a piece of something, and he dropped it into Johnny's bag. Johnny said, thank you very much. He ran back to Jimmy. He said, look, I did it. I trick-or-treated the old spooky place. Let's see what the man gave me. And he reached in his bag, and he pulled out a stick of gum. Had a black wrapper and a skull and crossbones on it. And Jimmy said, yuck, you're not going to eat that, are you? And Johnny said, no way. And Jimmy said, well, good job. Here's your granola bar, your gummy worms, and your M&Ms. And Jimmy went home, and Johnny went home. And when Johnny got home, he ate the granola bar, and then he ate some of those M&Ms. And then he said, gee, I wonder what that gum really looks like. So he decided he'd unwrap it and find out. So he did. He took the wrapper off, and he looked at it. It looked like a normal piece of gum. He said, boy, you know what? I bet it tastes terrible. I wonder what it does taste like. So he decided he'd bite off the corner just to find out, you know. Ooh, it tasted great. Tasted like wintergreen, spearmint, peppermint, all wrapped up into one. So he took the whole stick of gum and he stuck it in his mouth. When you know how you chew gum, after a while, doesn't taste so good?
Yes.
Yeah, the more you chew this gum, the better it tasted. So he didn't even eat any of his other trick-or-treat stuff. He just chewed that gum until it was time for bed. And when it was time for bed, he said, I'm going to chew this gum again tomorrow. So he took the gum out of his mouth, put it carefully over on his bedside table, brushed his teeth, and went to sleep. Well, he was lying there in bed. All of a sudden, he woke up, chewing the gum. This is funny. I know I took it out of my mouth. Well, he took it out of his mouth again. He put it back over on the table, and he went back to sleep. About 5 minutes later, he woke up. Chewing the gum. I know I took it out of my mouth. I took it out of his mouth. But this time, he put it over on his table, and he just lay there and watched it. Sure enough, after about 5 minutes, that gum started chewing by itself. Walked across his bedside table, jumped up on his bedpost, jumped down on Johnny's pillow, walked over to his face, and jumped back into his mouth. Johnny took the gum. He ran over to the window and he thought, "Throw it out in the backyard." Oh, was that weird? It gave him the heebie-jeebies and the willies real bad. Boy, it took him a long time to get back to sleep after that. And man, when he got up in the morning, he still had to go to school, you know.
Yeah.
So he's pretty tired. He's putting on his clothes. He's just sitting there on the edge of his bed, getting ready. And he looks over at the window, and there's the gum crawling back in the window. And he jumped on the floor and started crawling straight for Johnny.
Oh, no.
So he ran down the stairs in the kitchen. He got a jar. He ran back upstairs. He got the gum. He threw it in the jar. And then he put the top on tight. And then he punched some holes in the top so it wouldn't suffocate. And he put it over on his bedside table. And he went to school. Now, all day long at school, all Johnny could do was think about that gum. Can you imagine? And when he got home, he ran up the stairs to his house. He ran up the stairs to his room. He ran into his room, checking the gum. And while he was away, the gum had grown inside the jar. Now it was about as big as a baseball, just chewing away by itself inside that jar. Johnny said, "Oh, bad, 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 bad. I didn't want this ever to be. And it wasn't my idea to go to that old spooky place either. Yeah, but I better get some help." So he went downstairs. He took the jar, got downstairs. He says, Mom, hey, Mom. His mom came out and said, "What is it, Johnny?" "Mom, I have something I have to show you." "Oh, something you made at school?" "No, Mom, just look at this." She took one look at it. "Ah, what is that?" "Johnny, it's gross. What is that stuff?" "It's moving." "Not gonna believe it, Mom. It's haunted chewing gum. Oh, I don't care what it is. We can't have that around here. We have to get rid of it." "I know what we'll do. We'll bury it. We'll bury it out in the backyard, of course." So they went out in the backyard. They dug a hole about 4 feet deep. Yeah, took with the jar of the gum and put them at the bottom of the hole. Put the dirt back on top. And everything was okay for about a week. About a week. And then 1 week later, Johnny was sitting at breakfast and he was eating his Cheerios, you know, reading the back of the box. And he looked out in the back lawn and there where they buried the gum, he saw something he had never seen before. There was a mound of earth growing out of his backyard.
Oh.
A mound of earth. And then he saw, it's getting bigger. And it was getting bigger and bigger. This mound of earth was getting bigger and bigger and bigger. And suddenly out of the ground, woof, up this basketball-sized hunk of chewing gum, just chewing away by itself. And Johnny's mom saw it, Johnny saw it. They ran out in the backyard, and that basketball-sized hunk of chewing gum started chasing Johnny all around the backyard. So Johnny's mom, she got on the phone, she called the police. She said, "Get over here right away. There's some haunted chewing gum chasing my son around the backyard." "Lady, are you okay?" "Yeah, I'm fine, but I gotta get some problem. You gotta send me. Where are you guys?" And so next thing you know, police pull up on Johnny's house. Police come running upstairs. By this time, Johnny's hiding in a closet. The gum's outside the closet, just bam, bam, up against the closet door. Police come running upstairs, take one look at the gum and say, ma'am, there's not really much we can do here. See, we don't really have jurisdiction in, you know, besides, it really didn't do anything wrong. We can't arrest it. Best thing we could do for you would be to lock it in your garage. So that's the best thing they could do. So they took that big hunk of gum out to Johnny's garage and they locked it there. And then they just left. But every day, that gum got a little bit bigger. And bigger and bigger. And every day, and he would just go bam up against the garage door, getting louder. Bam and bam, more time. Bam. And Johnny knew that it wasn't going to be long. That thing was going to bust right out of there. And then what are we going to do? What are we going to do? And then Johnny remembered something. See, a couple of years before this all happened, one day, for no apparent reason, Johnny had stuck some gum in his sister's hair. He didn't mean to. He was a good boy. He just wasn't thinking. Because this is a terrible tragedy. He had gum in her hair, and they thought they were going to have to cut her hair to get the gum out. So they decided to call Grandma to see if she knew what to do, because Grandma always knows what to do. And Grandma said, "Have you tried peanut butter yet?" Peanut butter. Why peanut butter? Because peanut butter will melt the gum. So they did. They took a spoonful of peanut butter, put it into her hair, and mushed it around with that gum, and it caused that gum, that peanut butter caused that gum, just to melt right out of her hair. Don't try this at home. Well, Johnny remembered this moment, and he said, "I gotta get me some peanut butter. But I mean like a whole lot of peanut butter." So he went down to the local health food store. He bought 16 5-gallon buckets of peanut butter. Brought them all out to his house, dumped them all, took them all up on the roof, dumped them all out, and made one giant peanut butter ball on the roof of his house. And then he got his mom, he said, "Mom, get up on the roof, and you get there, and when that gum comes by, you just let him have it." And so, and Mom got up on the roof, and Johnny went over that garage door, and he opened up the door, and he said, "Nah, nah, 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 nah." Yeah. Oh, that's the other story. Okay. And next thing you know, the gums. He's lumbering out of the garage after Johnny. Johnny's running as fast as he can. The gum is coming and it's spun on the closet. And all of a sudden, Johnny says, "No, Mom! And Johnny, Mom, put a bit of mom!" Right out on top of that gum. It just melted in the ground. It left this big old grease spot where the grass would never. Now this happened, where do you go? I think Harrisburg, Pennsylvania. Have you ever heard of that place? In Harrisburg, right. Pennsylvania. And one of these days, your library is going to organize a field trip to go find a spot where that happened. Isn't this right, Jess? So you're going to go find this spot where this all happened, and then you're going to send me a picture of it. Because somewhere it must be a plaque or something, because that's where this story happened. But meanwhile, if somebody gives you a piece of gum, you be careful, because it might be haunted. That's the story of the haunted chewing gum.
Oh, that was great, Bill.
Wow. Wow.
I know.
What do you think, Whoa. Guys? It's well, amazing, here. Right?
Yeah, okay. That was. Thank you so much.
So much excitement.
The only thing that I could follow that would be a song about a walrus, don't you think?
Yeah, I think we have time for the walrus and then our little goodbye song.
Yeah, I think so, too. So I'm going to go back on the guitar and... Alan's going to go back on the bass, and you guys, we're all going to go up to the Arctic land and meet a wonderful creature. You see, in Radio Woof Land, I play some different characters, and one of them is a fabulous walrus named Lawrence the Walrus. And this is the song. In fact, it's all about what it would be like to be a walrus. So sing along, guys. Goes, "Oh, the walrus life is really grand, way up north in the Arctic land. With all of my friends and my family, the walrus life is the life for me. Well, I'm not a fish, I'm not a whale, I'm not a turtle, and I'm not a snail. I'm a walrus, and you know it's true. I really don't look a lot like you. Oh, the walrus life is really grand, way up north in the Arctic land. With all of my friends and my family, the walrus life is the life for me. When I go down
to the sea to swim. I flap my tail, I flip my fins, I swim about most everywhere, and now and then I come up for air. Oh, thou walrus life is really grand, way up north in the Arctic land, with all of my friends and my family. The walrus life is the life for me. Well, I don't mind the snow and ice. In fact, I think they're really nice. I can swim about in a winter storm, 'cause I got a lot of blubber to keep me warm. Oh, the walrus life is really grand. Way up in the Arctic land, with all of my friends and my family. Oh, the walrus life is a lot for me. Let's hear it for walrus living. Wow, good job, right, guys. Well, as we said at the beginning in our very first song, all good things must come to an end. And we have had such a great time today. Yeah. And we want to thank especially the Susquehanna Folk Festival, York Libraries, Dauphin County Library System, and Hershey Library for helping make this happen so we could meet you, you could meet us, and we could all be together today for this really fun time. So again, thank you.
Thank you.
We'd like to leave you a little song about goodbye, because there's so many ways to say goodbye around the world. We're just going to say just a few of them.
Okay. Oh, yes, can you
see them? Well, yeah, I think I know how the first one goes. It goes, we must say goodbye now. We must say goodbye now. We must say goodbye now. We won't be gone for long. Try it again. We must say goodbye now. We must say goodbye now. We must say goodbye now. But we won't be gone. Say adios. We must say adios. We must say adios. We must say adios, but we won't be gone for long. Arrivederci. We must say arrivederci. We must say, that's Italian, yeah. We must say arrivederci, but we won't be gone.
Au revoir.
We must say au revoir. We must say au revoir. We must say au revoir, but we won't be.
How about cheerio?
We must say cheerio. We must say cheerio. We must say cheerio, but we won't.
I got one for Allan.
Well, we must say see you later, alligator. We must say see you later. We must say see you later, alligator. After a while, crocodile. But we won't be gone for long. Thanks, everybody. Have a great summer.
Let's have a bye-bye. Good Beverly
Bye.
Street. Goodbye. Beverly. Thank you. Goodbye.
Bye.
Thank
Bye.
You.
Bye.
Thanks, everybody.
Thank you so much. Sayonara.
Thanks, Dave.
Yep. Should I remove everybody from the?
Sure. We can all leave. All right. Thanks for coming.
We love the music and the storytelling.
Yeah. Thanks, Peggy. Great to see you.
Yeah,
oh, yeah. Don't remove everybody. but the band's still here.
Oh, no, my 11 and 13-year-old were happy to sing along. They just didn't want to be on the screen for much of it, but yeah. All of us really enjoyed your performance. Thank you so much.
That's wonderful. Peggy, thanks for coming on. Peggy's a wonderful singer herself, so she knows all about it. So
yeah, love it all. Hope to see